Let's start small.
Okay. Come on, let's go. The girl left. She left me in the pasture with this weird stuff on me. I don't know what just happened. I thought that's what she wanted me to do. All she was doing was kicking me. I had to get this stuff off. I didn't know what it was. Why would she leave me in here with it on? I tried to get off, but it wouldn't come off. What was a horse to do in this situation? I didn't know what was going on. I mean, she wasn't mean like my other owner, but she could at least tell me what this was. What was on me? Why did she get on me? I couldn't carry her. A few hours later, the girl came back. Hi, Heartbreaker. Let's try. Now that you're used to your tack, maybe I can try riding you. From hearing the girl talk, I now learned that this stuff on me was called tack. And this was a saddle, and a saddle pad, and a bridle. Was she trying to get on me again? What was I gonna do? Come on. Come on, boy, come on. She was kicking again. I still didn't know what to do. Come on, Heartbreaker, walk. Oh, this time she said walk as she kicked. I understood what walk was, so I walked. Good boy. Walk. I was walking, I was doing it. Someone was riding me. Now I understood that this was easier than it looked. I still didn't know what was going to come, but I knew I had this down. Trot, boy, trot. What was a trot? What? Come on. She squeezed a little harder this time. I was already walking. What else did she want? Well, then I thought to myself, if I'm walking and she wants more, maybe step it up a little bit. So I did just that. I started trotting. Good boy. What a good boy. I told that girl that was mean to you, you had potential. You'll have a great life here. That's enough for today. You've done so well. You deserve a rest. Good boy. Come on, let's go. I'll untack you now. There we go. Good stuff. She took off the thing wrapping around my belly. It felt so much better. Now the saddle came off, as I'm now told it is called. I was sweating, but it felt good to have it off. I was free of all that heavy stuff. Cold metal inside my mouth, a bit, bridle, a sweat. sweaty saddle. Felt so good. Time for you to get some rest. Hey boy, you had a long day. You learned how to let me ride you. We just need to see how you are at jumping. Tomorrow, we'll start your jump training. You need a lot of rest for that. I'll bring you some food. Jumping? Finally? I couldn't wait to learn how to jump and show that horse champion how good I really was. For years of living next to him in that barn, all he did was tell me how I was no good. But I was gonna learn to jump tomorrow. Too bad I didn't know what it came with. The girl returned with food. I was very hungry for my long day. Hi, Heartbreaker. Here's your food. See you tomorrow. I was tired and needed rest, so I decided to go to sleep. The next morning, the girl came back. I wondered why. Hi, Heartbreaker. Before your training today, I'm going to put you out in the pasture. You need some running time so you don't freak out. Oh, yay, the pasture. It was one of my favorite things. Go ahead, boy. As I was in the pasture, I recognized another horse, but I wasn't quite sure. Who was this horse? I knew her from somewhere. Then it hit me. It was my mother! My mother that I was taken from when I was a fool. Mother? Heartbreaker! It's you, it's really you. I missed you so much. How are you here? How'd you get to this barn? The same girl that bought you bought me. Really? No way. Oh my gosh. I see you found your mother, Heartbreaker. I did that on purpose. I knew she was. I did my research, and that's why I bought you from that mean girl. As my way of saying thank you to her, even though she couldn't understand horses. This was the happiest moment of my life. Come on, Heartbreaker, it's time to train you. Bye, Mother. I'll see you soon. Bye, honey. I love you. I'm so glad that we're at the same barn. Me too. I didn't know what was to come. I thought I would just be more walking and trotting, but I was wrong. I was now used to the bridle and saddle, so she started to tack me up. I gave her no problems. Although I was still angry about the tight around my belly of that girth, I let her put it on. She had given me my mother back. The least I could do was cooperate. Good boy, Heartbreaker. Let's go. She slipped the reins over my head just before she got on. Okay, now that you're familiar with walking and trotting, let's canter. Come on, boy. I started to canter. Wasn't as hard as I thought. Good. Now that you've got that down, we can set up some jumps. There we go. Just nice and easy, Heartbreak. What was this weird-looking obstacle in front of me? I didn't know what to do. She wanted me to jump that, but it was so scary-looking. Come on. Easy, easy. I had spooked at the jump. It was a lot harder than it seemed. The poles were reset, and I had to try again. But I was just too afraid. I didn't want to jump it. What if it jumped out at me? Come on, boy, it's okay. Don't worry. I know you're a horse, and I know you're scared. You just don't understand. I know you can do it, Heartbreaker. One more time. I know you can do it. You did it! Good boy!